Welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Locheny. Today, Senator George Maziarz is here to talk about the New York Safe Act, damaging flooding this summer, as well as the Teacher of the Year who was in his district. Hi, Senator.
Hi, Julia. How are you?
Good. How are you doing?
Another week under our belts here and getting ready to go.
Yeah, it's the second week of budget hearings.
Right.
So I want to talk to you now. The people of Lockport, North Tonawanda, and Niagara Falls experienced ruinous flooding.
Yes, this summer it was very unusual. We had two disastrous floods in the first one, the end of June, concentrated on the eastern end of Niagara County. There's Senator Schumer, Mayor Mike Tucker there is on the left, the first responders. We were meeting with Senator Schumer about some FEMA business. The first flood concentrated on Lockport, eastern end of Niagara County, and the second one in mid-July was in the western end of Niagara County, Niagara Falls, town of Niagara, town of Wheatfield, a little bit of Lewiston, and North Tonawanda. I learned a lot about FEMA designations, and the governor was very gracious at the time. He added Niagara County to the Mohawk Valley flood relief emergency disaster declaration that he did at that time. This legislation that the Senate passed last week is called the Mohawk Valley Niagara County Relief Act. Basically, what that does is it allows the local municipalities to give assessment relief to those homes that were damaged in the flood. I can tell you, I've lived in Niagara County my entire life. I've never seen, you see there a local restaurant. There was water, food floating all over the place. It was just terrible. And, I know that the governor's office is still working. Some people, there's a guy that was, I think, on the national news. He was paddling down his street in a kayak. Many of the residents who have filed for relief, some of them were covered by the private insurance companies. Others did get some assistance from the state of New York, but some are still waiting for that assistance. This legislation, there's actually three pieces. One would give an assessment relief for those properties that were damaged in this year's property tax bill. Mm-hmm. The second one would give people an income tax credit. If they're not going to get a check for relief, maybe they can at least use the damage as a credit against their state income tax. And the third bill would create a New York State disaster recovery program to allow people to access some funds to rebuild their home that are not covered by FEMA. We waited so long for an official FEMA designation. Senator Schumer's office was very helpful, but there's a threshold that you have to meet as far as the amount of a monetary threshold that you have to meet as far as the amount of damage. Then there's a secondary problem, which is equally important, but the municipal wastewater treatment plants, both in the Niagara Falls wastewater treatment plant and in the city of Lockport wastewater treatment plant, the plants were overwhelmed with inflow of water. I'm not a technical expert in this area, but I toured both plants along with the Senator Schumer and Lieutenant Governor Bob Duffy, and you could see that the when the water was coming in, the pumps that actually move the water around the wastewater treatment plant is treated before it goes back out as clean water. The pumping rooms were overwhelmed. They were overflowing with wastewater and water and everything. The pumps were ruined, so these two facilities suffered millions of dollars worth of damage, some of which is going to be covered by FEMA and by the federal government. This legislation really is concentrating on homeowners and on getting relief for homeowners. So we passed all three bills. I believe all of them passed unanimously in the Senate. They've been sent over to the Assembly now. We do have, because this flooding happened both in the Mohawk Valley region and in Niagara County, we do have sponsors on both sides. So that's hopefully it's going to get some relief.
Yeah, that's really important. And it's good that you got it done so early on in
session. Yes, yeah. I know that the homeowners in Niagara County, particularly on the western end, the Niagara Falls end, and to some degree the Lockport end too, are they've been waiting a long time. And they suffered some pretty severe. Paddle a canoe down the middle of your street, you can imagine what your basement looked like. You saw the restaurant there. That business is gone. That business is ruined. You can't, with the molding issues and the mm-hmm. that building will have to be torn down.
So anyone who is looking for more information can go on your website.
Go on my website, call my office, whatever, we'll get them. Hopefully right now what we really have to do is move the assembly to pass these bills.
So you participated in an event to protest the New York Safe Act gun control legislation.
Yes. There I am at the Tonawanda Sportsman's Club in the town of, it's actually located in the town of Pendleton. Myself and probably, maybe 50 or 60 other Second Amendment supporters fired the shot to be heard around New York State right at noon. They're good people. I'm vehemently opposed to the SAFE Act. I co-sponsoring legislation to repeal the act. Hopefully, we're going to win in the courts. I saw Tom King, the president of the New York Rifle and Pistol Association, last week here in Albany. We talked briefly about the court case, and things are moving along. Hopefully, we're going to get some relief there this year. It's a priority of mine. I've been meeting with organizations, hunting groups, in my Senate district. I believe I have a meeting scheduled next week with some other interests there, with the SCOPE and the Federation of Sportsmen's Clubs.
All right, so you're trying to appeal it, and you never voted for it anyway.
I did not. I voted against it, vehemently opposed to it. I think it was maybe in all the years I've been here, maybe the poorest piece of legislation that I've ever seen drafted and acted upon here.
Right. And talk about the process a little bit, how that went.
Well, it didn't go very well. Obviously it was an emotional response to what happened, the tragedy at Sandy Hook, and it was a tragedy. The problem with this legislation is it wouldn't prevent another Sandy Hook. I mean, bad people are going to be able to access guns. They're not the people that are following the law. Mm-hmm. It's the good people that, shop at places like Johnson's Country Store in Lockport that are hampered by this type of legislation. I was glad to see that Judge Scretany in Buffalo did rule against the seven-round limit. I don't think the judge went far enough, but I was at least it was at least one positive to see that he saw that was unconstitutional. And now both sides, of course, are appealing that. So I'm not an attorney, but I think this thing is probably going to end up before the United States Supreme Court, which the last two decisions before the U.S. Supreme Court have been very favorable for gun owners. So, hopefully we'll get there. Just we have to get there expeditiously as possible.
Right. More on your website, maziarz.nysenate.gov. Yes. Last week when you were here, we were talking about the Common Core, and you mentioned that you had the Teacher of the Year from your district. And I believe you got to meet her?
Ashley Dreyer. Yes, I did. There she is. She teaches at Lewiston Porter a school system in Niagara County. I have to tell you, she and the other state teachers of the year are going to meet with President Obama. She was asking us what she should say to the President of the United States. But we had a reception celebrating that great honor, and I have to tell you, she is one remarkable woman. It was really heartening. Every once in a while in this business, you go to a lot of dinners, a lot of celebrations, a lot of events, and sometimes they just sort of are normal routine. You go from one to the other, and sometimes you walk out of one, you're like walking on air, and you say, man, that really made me feel good. This was one of those occasions. Ashley was honored by the administration of the Lewport School District, Superintendent Chris Roser, by the building principals, and by her peers, but mostly I think by her students that were there. Ashley teaches special education. Many of her students were there, both current and former students. Mother, and sometimes again you get to these events and you get something really memorable. One mother who was there with her son, who was a student of Ashley's, he's very obviously a developmentally disabled child, a challenged child, and she said to me, when my son was like 2 years old, she said, the doctor sat down with my husband and I, and he told us to be prepared for a very difficult life, that our son would never be able to read, that he would not be able to function to a very high level, you know, and that we should prepare ourselves, accept that, you know, and just go on with life. And she said, you know, my son was very fortunate to get Ashley Dreyer as a teacher. She said, today my son can read. He's, you know, he's obviously still challenged, but she said he reads, he enjoys life, he does so many good things. You know, she introduced me to her son who was there. And that was just one. I mean, these parents got up and one after another talked about, you know, how their children's lives were changed by this particular teacher. You know, and it's clearly not an easy job, you know, when you're teaching students with challenges, you know, that are developmentally disabled. And I sat next to her at the dinner and she told me, she said, you know, I love my job. She said, I can hardly wait to go to work. She says, I love it when a parent comes in, you know, on the first day of school with a new student and they tell me, Johnny or Susie is very difficult, just some very basic learning things. And she said, you don't worry. By the end of the year, your son or daughter is going to be performing to a level that you never expected. And just about every parent that was there said that absolutely came true. So I can't say, I hope, you know, I what I suspect happens is, you know, they have a state teacher of the year and then they go into some sort of a competition and become the national teacher of the year. And, you know, I obviously I'm not real objective about it. I'd love to see Ashley become the National Teacher of the Year. She really deserves it. And she was a single parent. She is a single parent herself and, you know, raising two beautiful kids and just a great story. I got to tell you, I walked out of there thinking, this is a good part of life.
Yeah, it seems like she went into that profession for the right reasons, and that really makes a difference.
She sure did, and I have to tell you, she was telling me, you know, all the continuing education things that she has done, you know, to further her career, to learn more about teaching these special children, and it's just a great story. I know that when she was chosen, there was a flurry of news articles and I've told some of my friends in the media, there's a great story here to be told. I mean, you talk to some of those parents about those kids, and one of the parents got up there and actually broke down during the course of her talk about what a great teacher Ashley was, because, you know, she told a story about how the doctor told her when her child was very young, you know, just a baby, you know, expect the worst, be prepared for the worst, and they did. She said, you know, my husband and I said, you know, we are going to listen to this doctor. He knows what he's talking about. He said, and I think she said at the time, she said, unfortunately, that doctor had never met Ashley Dreyer because she proved him wrong.
That's really great.
Yeah, it is a great story.
Yeah. So the executive budget is being analyzed?
Being analyzed. The budget hearings are going on. Senator DeFrancisco from 10 to 10, I think he told me. Last week they had a bunch of really good organizations testifying. Of course, everybody wants more in the budget, more than what we have, but we're operating from a pretty good position, I think. You know, I'm very concerned about school aid. The school aid runs have come out. You know, some districts I think need some adjusting, clearly, so we're working on that now.
Very good. And just one more note, it is really nice to hear that about the teacher, because right now with all of the struggle in school and just the testing and stuff,
you don't
really hear that anymore.
It is,
Yeah. Thank you so much for being with us, Senator.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator George Maziarz. For additional information on the 2014 budget process, SAFE Act, and flooding relief legislation, maziarz.nysenate.gov.